When the day of Pentecost had finally arrived, they were all together in the same place. Suddenly there came from heaven a noise like the sound of a strong blowing wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Then tongues, seemingly made of fire, appeared to them, moving apart and coming to rest on each one of them. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them the words to say. There were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem at that time. When they heard this noise, they came together in a crowd. They were deeply puzzled, because every single one of them could hear them speaking in his or her own native language. They were astonished and amazed. "These men who are doing the speaking are all Galileans, aren't they?" they said. "So how is it that each of us can hear them in our own mother tongues?" "There are Parthians here, and Medians, Elamites, people from Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, Asia, Phrygia, and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the parts of Libya that belong to Cyrene. There are people from Rome, proselytes as well as Jews. There are Cretans and Arabs. We can hear them telling us about the powerful things that God has done in our own language." Everyone was astonished and perplexed. "What does it all mean?" they were asking each other. But some sneered. "Ugh, they're full of new wine," they said. Then Peter got up with the 11. He spoke to them in a loud voice. "People of Judea," he began, "all of you staying here in Jerusalem, there's something you have to know. Listen to what I'm saying. These people aren't drunk, as you imagine. It's only 9 o'clock in the morning. No. This is what the prophet Joel was talking about when he said, 'In the last days, declares God, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and your daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Yes, even on slaves, men and women alike, will I pour out my spirit in those days, and they shall prophesy. And I will give signs in the heavens above and portents on earth beneath, blood and fire and clouds of smoke. The sun will be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the day of the Lord comes, the great and glorious day. And then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved.'" This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Perdida So much has changed in our world lately.
疫情中这么多人失去生命，显明了生命的脆弱与短暂。
Pero la asombrosa gracia y amor de Jesús es más fuerte que la vida y la muerte.
Wo auch immer du bist, ruf seinen Namen an. Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Isa Masih.
Jesucristo.
Jesus.
Jesus. Yeshua.
Yeshua.
Jesus.
Don't wait another day.
Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what
rejected.
May the God of love bring us back to himself, forgive us our sins, and assure us of his eternal love in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Can you imagine being part of that gathering in the passage that we heard? As the people are filled with the Holy Spirit, they begin to speak in tongues, in a different language to their native tongue. And the other nationalities understand that. There's this amazing mix-up of worship and evangelism happening in this passage. It says in Acts 2, verse 11, that all these visitors to Jerusalem, and there's 15 nationalities that are listed, they not only hear their languages spoken, but hear God's wonders being declared too. So as the early church praises God, the crowds of foreigners there also hear about what God has done, and they too come to faith. And as they heard, barriers came tumbling down, bridges arose, and the new humanity in Christ began to emerge. During lockdown, I've been reading some books written by Bishop Michael Curry. I'm sure most of you will remember Bishop Michael's captivating talk on love at the royal wedding in 2018. Certainly a character. Well, I'd highly recommend that his books, and particularly the one called Crazy Christians. In this book, he mentions another book called Manna and Mercy, a brief history of God's unfolding promise to mend the entire universe. And that's written by Daniel Erlander. And Bishop Michaels says that Erlander combed through the Gospels to make a list of the types of people that Jesus encountered. This is that list: lepers, prostitutes, tax collectors, sinners, poor people, discarded people, blind people, debtors, outcasts, children, women, men, elderly people, sick people, Gentiles, Samaritans, Jews, the demon-possessed, outsiders, heretics, Pharisees, lawyers, rich people. Erlander then made a list of the verbs that the gospel used to describe how Jesus related to these people. Invited, included, affirmed, loved, touched, liberated, held, embraced, healed, cleansed, given dignity, fed, forgiven, made whole, called, reborn, given hope, received, honoured, freed. The outcome of an encounter with Jesus was and is the kind of new life that Jesus offered. Jesus excluded no one. He held nothing back. He built bridges among people and they gained new life. That's what happened and happens when Jesus is around. Not a single person excluded, not a single grace held back. Bishop Michael goes on to say that as Jesus' followers, we understand that the work of the gospel, the core of discipleship, is to follow our Saviour in the way of God, breaking down dividing walls and divisive barriers, and building up bridges of reconciliation that lead to a new humanity, a new creation, a new heaven, and a new earth. The mission of the church is part of the Anglican tradition right from the beginning in the 16th century. And a great theologian of that time, Richard Hooker, is reported to have said this: "I pray that no one will be offended if I seek to make the Christian religion an inn where all are received joyously, rather than a cottage where some few friends or the family are to be received." The good news of God's love is about reconciliation, because of Jesus reconciling us to God and to each other. The gospel can transform people and society, even though people and society are so diverse. Bishop Michael says this, and I just love this sentence in his book: "The gospel transforms from the world's nightmare of division into God's intention for reconciliation." I wonder how this applies to us today. Maybe take a little time to ponder and also to listen to the next song and reflect on the words.
In a time full of war, be peace. In a time full of doubt, just believe. Yeah, there ain't that much difference between you and me. In a time full of war, we'll be peace. In a world full of hate, be a light. When you do somebody wrong, make it right. Don't hide in the dark, you were born to shine. That needs change and make a difference. In a time full of noise, just listen. 'Cause life is but a breeze, better live it. In a place that needs a change, make a difference. In a world full of hate, be a light.
Cause the finish line is 6 feet in the ground.
In a race you can't win, just slow it down.
In a world full of hate, be alive.
See black and white in a world full of hate. Be a light.
Avule di la masango,
ay ay
ay oh,
ay ay
ay oh,
ay ay
ay oh, oh.
Amen.
Avule di la masango,
ay ay
ay
ay
oh.
Oh,